Bacteria cause infections all around the world, all sorts of different infections. Millions and millions of people around the world succumb to these infections, and we've used antibiotics for 50, 60, 70 years around the world to prevent and to treat these infections, and unfortunately, because of that use of antibiotics, bacteria have become resistant to those antibiotics, and so that means that increasing numbers of infections are not treatable. Two of the most threatening bacteria that we see all around the world, in the UK and in Thailand, are E. coli and Klebsiella pneumoniae, and they're really threatening organisms because they're carried around in the intestines of humans and animals, and so wherever there's human waste, these bacteria are present. They can cause a whole range of different diseases, from urinary tract infections all the way through to bloodstream infections, which have got a 40 to 50% mortality rate. Resistance to antibiotics in these particular species has been increasing all around the world, but particularly in South and Southeast Asia. The aim initially is to look at sampling the environment, see what resistance is present within the environment, what resistant bacteria are there, and also to consider what might be causing that. And once you've got a handle on what sort of chemical and biological drivers they might be, we want to start to understand why those wastes and those pollutants are getting into the environment and what we might be able to do about it. So we're talking about human behaviours, we're talking about why people use antibiotics in a certain way, why people farm in a certain way, why pollutants get into the environment, and whether or not we can work with the Thai authorities to try and suggest alternative ways of working which would reduce the levels of antibiotic resistance, reducing the health with the impact on health of antibiotic resistance in Thailand, but also learn things that can be transferred across the world, because many of these drivers are common to many countries around the world. One of the reasons why I decided to go down the GCRF route for applying for funding is that I wanted to make a significant impact on an ODA country. I'd got some links with Thailand already, and I felt that there was something we could do to help the Thai government make decisions about the way that they were going to fund and work in their own country. So we worked closely with our Thai colleagues and ended up generating a project which we feel is going to be greatly beneficial to them and also to the wider world.